Hello everybody, and welcome to the new UK radio show. My name is Kevin Smith, and I have a few things to share with you. I thought I'd begin by musing over the trait of empathy. So what exactly is this? It is the ability to put oneself in another person's shoes, to see and experience from another's perspective, to be able, in essence, to share another's attitude or emotional reaction to a situation that we are not experiencing ourselves. Okay, that might not be the standard definition, and perhaps a little skewed, but close enough, I would say. I like how David Icke explains it, and that is as the fail-safe mechanism for behaviour, especially the more extreme. If one is unable to put oneself in another's shoes and empathise with that person's predicament, especially if we are the cause of that individual's grief, as an example, there is now no limit to what one is capable of. The ability to see something from another's perspective in this empathic manner would be along the lines of viewing something from a different perspective or objective. And this would be in keeping with awareness. One indication of an individual who is completely disconnected from their real awareness and the real self, that is, with these, would be their inability to view situations, experiences, and themselves objectively. An unaware person would be completely immersed in the experience of not only what was external to them, but immersed in the experience of being themselves. They would be utterly involved with their created little selves, their personal vehicles, and quite incapable of regarding themselves with objectivity. Being in such a state of decided, imposed confinement ensures a mighty disconnect from who they really are, real beings of real light in the real universes. Their vehicles are simply creations of the real individual, animated to experience the psych realms for the sole purpose of becoming more aware and ultimately superseding them. So, as the individual becomes aware of their vehicles, becomes aware they are in fact with the is and animating their vehicles, then it becomes apparent that everything these vehicles are, their traits and mannerisms, are not the individual, but simply a tool for determining what the is, through experiencing what it is not. And the is not creation, and the five vehicles that have experiences within the matrix that stem from it. So naturally then, awareness will have an individual more so being objective. Instead of immersing oneself in everything and identifying with the vehicles, then the individual will begin to be more detached and indifferent from not only the vehicles and their emotional, mental makeup, but also the experiences they find themselves in. All experiences, too, are brought forth by decisions and choices we make, and so by our own creation, in effect, along with the creations of others that we must deal with. But every experience is another opportunity, another step to becoming more aware. Regardless of the nature of the experience, be it good, bad, or indifferent. And we can begin to see the patterns of what we set in motion through our thoughts, emotions, and ideas, and the resulting cause and effect consequences we then experience. But even with harsh experiences, if viewed objectively, the objective, detached view of the real you can take the sting out of them to a degree. And instead then of having harsh experiences and then adding more ideas to them, along the lines of perhaps how unfair and why me, etc., and then enhancing those ideas with the emotion to match, the rage or feelings of remorse, shame, and various other decided upon woes, we can cease the reactionary practiced responses, thoughts, and emotions we usually release, and instead simply observe, like witnessing a scene. For if we continue to react with emotions, then habitual situations, which are then coupled with the same emotional responses, become charged ideas and can be stored in our causal bodies. And so we end up with an entire causal body database of automatic responses to certain situations or triggers that we will carry with us, not only throughout this lifetime, but beyond it, and on, until we choose to break the pattern and choose a different reaction, or ideally no emotional reaction at all. And so, who knows what ingrained, self-programmed responses we have lurking in our causal bodies, waiting to be unleashed when the matching trigger situation is experienced. This is how Manchurian candidates work. Programmed responses to certain stimuli, with the entire program having been erased from the candidate due to trauma-based techniques. A little similar, then, to those emotional-charged reactions we store in our causal body. They become forgotten too, but remain and can be activated at any time. We are, in fact, experiencers. We are not the experience, for how can we be? If we are in the real universes with the is, and we are animating the five vehicles from there, it is akin to playing a computer game. The real you is the experiencer, watching the monitor and utilizing the mouse and the keyboard, which we can have as analogies for the five vehicles in creation. Or maybe, for a better picture, we are one of those computer game guys who has five computers running simultaneously. Five characters in their five little worlds, but all animated and controlled by the real you. From here, we are hardly likely to get embroiled in the experience of the games, because we are viewing them objectively, Naturally, we care about the characters, but are hardly likely to have emotional outpourings if, say, one of our characters has an argument with another aggressive computer character. I'm not sure that's a great analogy, but it works for me. So, getting back to the whole idea of empathy, the ability to put oneself in another's shoes, it is a little like objectively viewing. With awareness comes the ability to see things from endless viewpoints, as essentially everything and everyone is. And thus, ultimately, this objective viewing must be possible from any position. And there would be a point where one could not, you might imagine, differentiate themselves from anything else. Unless the individual wanted to, for the purposes of sharing and giving others the opportunity to become more aware, such as the guides do. Imagine then what such a position would be like, being everything and everything being you, a position impossible to fathom, at least from the position of the personal self. Naturally, we lack the facility to fathom it, particularly if we lean to the mental vehicle for our fathoming. Even the imagination and intuition, far more advanced they may be, but still vehicles in creation, and lacking the perception to see the is, they being only the doorway to the real awareness. And so, the qualities of being with the is would be a being isness, sincerity and purity, and all other qualities that stem from our vehicles in creation, our ideas and emotions, would fall short of the state of being required to be with the true reality. For every emotion we activate in creation stems from our astral body, and as creation is a simulation, so must all emotions and states of being that are created in it. All ideas too, those created and decided upon, such as dignity and hope and faith, especially if they are associated with ideas such as religion and spirituality, as these are ideas created in creation, and if agreed to, will have us tap-lined and restricted too. So, personality traits must fall under the same limiting criteria. As we have created the bodies, we also create the personalities that go with them. Interestingly, it has been determined that personality traits are in fact genetic in their origins. People are more inclined to be angry, aggressive, or apathetic according to which parts of their genetic database is switched on or off. Of course, we construct our created consciousness as we go through our lifetimes, and we tend to get attached to certain ways of being that seem to work for us. People become more so dictators or slavish in their personality as they carry on with what seems familiar, reinforce their created personality further by doing just that, and likely cementing future lifetimes as being a slave or slave master, as an example, by projecting this way of being and agreeing upon it into their next incarnation. So it's interesting that genetics can also affect the personality traits of theoretically an entire species or subrace of peoples. This is why we can see certain races of peoples who are more inclined to be a certain way than others, perhaps more warlike or more subservient, more enthusiastic or apathetic. I used to consider, this is going back to my spiritual idea days, how is it then that we can be, quote, unquote, spiritual and loving, as that was the thing to be back then, if genetics dictated our ability to be so? How can we seemingly be graded on our ability to be loving and spiritual, to have only loving thoughts, etc., if our very genetic makeup that we received from our lineage was coloured, as an example, with aggressive tendencies? Of course, we now know how the vehicles are just that, and anything that is affecting them in any way has nothing to do with our real awareness. And in fact, the notions of love and loving everything is just an idea in creation, because any emotion, regardless of what it is simulated and created from the astral vehicle, and thus it isn't real. Real love can only be found in the real universes, beyond the holographic training grounds that is creation. Anything in creation, then, is a faint echo of the real thing, and falls short. And so we can see that anything that is hindering our ability to express a certain trait due to genetics of the physical vehicle has nothing to do with our real awareness, and so will not hinder us in our journeys to the is. Going back then to where I started, David Icke speaking of empathy, he also contended that empathy had been deleted from the reptilians, that they were then a race more capable as a result of perpetrating the atrocities that they do, because they have no pangs of remorse that the trait of empathy would cause. He also speculated that the human race was having its empathy shut off too, for similar reasons, that humans would then not be so outraged and upset by that which is propagated by the controllers, the wars, the slaughters, and sufferings of millions the world over. This can certainly be seen, the dulling of people to the extent that a great apathy and disinterest in the plight of others is prevalent through an extensive desensitizing of people through what they are subjected to, and through the increasing level of violence and extreme visuals through entertainment. So, although people will react or not as a result of desensitizing them, and the possible flicking on and off of certain genetic traits to create the kind of slaves that will be apathetic and uncaring, this can only take effect if the individual is focused entirely on the physical astral levels of themselves. If awareness is connected to, and continuously so through focus and real intent, then the individual will supersede any limitations on the physical vehicle, and they then become irrelevant, such as the health of the body, Yes, maintenance is important, but it has nothing to do with real awareness. And so, any genetic traits an individual has assumed due to having a life this time around in a certain bloodline and temporarily inheriting these traits for next time, they will be inserted in a different bloodline. This has nothing to do then with their real awareness either. So, yes, it's conceivable that the reptilians have, through their collective, agreed, constructed consciousnesses over many thousands of years and lifetimes, through their collective choices and decisions, resulted in physical reptilian vehicles where the physical genetic trait of empathy has been deleted. So they are more inclined to take over creation and do what they do. It would follow then that an individual who decides upon being tyrannical begins to go along that path of creating their consciousness in that way would sooner or later align themselves with a species that resembled such a state of being. A person going down the path of evil intents and being would most likely project into a future and be a part of a species where they are collectively this way. The reptilians, with their ability to empathize, switched off, as an example, and vice versa. A reptilian who begins to align themselves and decide upon a different way of being that is no longer in alignment with the reptilian species may well find themselves becoming a human in the next lifetime, as an example. It is so that the human is considered, as a species, an evolutionary step above the reptilians in regard to awareness potential, and so it follows that as an individual chooses ways of being more in keeping with, or at least creational echoes of the qualities of those required to be with the is, then that individual will go through the various species to a species that is collectively more likely to have the awareness to begin the process of recognizing the is. Generally, a reptilian would have little interest in this. So baroque their decided way of being that an individual of this nature would find themselves as a reptilian in a more limited expression of experience, a position and species in keeping with what they have decided for themselves. And so, in a kind of long and rambling way, I get to the point that empathy, or lack of it, would be an issue in regards to how a species conducts themselves and interacts with others, but only if that species or any individual within it was locked entirely into their personal little self, with no connection to their real awareness, and thus at the mercy of the collective agreed-upon genetic drawbacks. With real awareness, we would supersede the restriction of our vehicles by viewing everything objectively as just the experiences that they are. And we'd also ensure we are not dragged into the emotional baiting of what is occurring in our collective experiences also. Because anything emotional, and we become the effects of it and restrict ourselves. And the controllers know this, at least those in the know and certainly the Callum God, from where this all stems from. He will delight in all the emotional reaction to the daily wars and injustices, as the slaves are simply digging themselves in deeper by emotionally reacting to a world they subconsciously agree to. So, in a way, is lack of empathy a burden? If by having empathy we react with a far greater degree of outrage, anxiety, and heartache, then this is even more so overstimulation of the emotional astral vehicle, with far greater than cause and effect consequences. Far more emotionally charged ideas that get locked in our causal bodies to result in similar extreme reactions to the same stimuli in future lifetimes. Then having empathy deleted or absent might in fact be preferable. This would ideally need to be coupled with awareness, or the lack of empathy would result in a far greater likelihood of committing heinous acts. Because through awareness, we see people being to being, and understand the cause and effect nature of creation. And this knowledge would act as regulators of our behaviour, more so than a physical genetic trait of empathy. For aware individuals would surely not choose to act murderously, knowing the cause and effect future lifetimes they would be subjecting themselves to. And with more awareness, we view everything here, regardless of how evil, with detachment and disinterest, or we become the effects of the emotional responses we choose to add to the experience. After all, using the sun as the example, does it get emotionally involved in what it has witnessed for the span of time it has been shining over the atrocities occurring on the planet Earth? It may sound somewhat harsh a state to be in, but everything here is a simulation, and everybody has chosen, through their decisions, the position and circumstances they find themselves in, what they have agreed to, etc. And besides, sometimes the harder the situation, the more valuable it is as an experience and an incentive to want to position ourselves better and leave creation behind. And with real awareness, everyone can supersede cause and effect creation and move beyond whatever position they have found themselves in. For no, we can't save the world. We can't save anyone, in fact. Everyone must save themselves by choosing and deciding to become more aware, and eventually recognizing the real universes and the is. For if we imposed upon situations and tyrants, we are violating their free will, and everyone has the right to choose whatever they will. And getting drawn into the battle, even if it is a fight against evil, we become the effects of whichever side we choose, good or evil. It is the dualistic nature of creation, and we become the effects of it. As a final note, I once had a dream where I was granted an objective view. Some of our experiences on the real side run along these lines. being in the skin of another species for the purpose of seeing from their perspective. So when I was saying how when we are with the is, we would be everything simultaneously, one can imagine viewing from every position at the same time. But in the meantime, we have these experiences to where we view from the perspective of an assortment of creatures and individuals. For every objective view helps us to become more aware, to see how, with different species, they have different agreed and decided upon ideas that they incorporate into their personal selves, and how they are different from species to species. So as an individual, as you are afforded these various objective views, you have the impression of not only wearing the different vehicles, but wearing the personality and ideas, attachments, both with the individual and its species collectively. It impresses upon you how these are just ideas added to what we are, that is, a real being of light, and so, again, a comparison to what the is not, to figure out what it is. So yes, I had a view in this dream as a reptilian, and in that form I took on temporarily the traits of said reptilian and that of its species. The species seem to have a lot of innate information, or a reptilian's particular brand of programmed indoctrination locked into every reptilian's causal body. It was along the lines of religion. It had that kind of restrictive flavour of limitation about it, and it was accessible through my mental vehicle, ingrained into myself, as I said, through the causal, with knowledge even of the Callum God. So it was a fascinating view for awareness purposes from the vehicle of a reptilian, and indeed, as I understand it, many reptilians are getting on board with the new presentation too. And as they like to lurk on the astral and move amongst us unseen on the physical in that manner, you may have a reptilian listening right beside you while you are on a new presentation Skype, as an example, or especially if you sing the new you song. Sandy Staling can see these reptilians on the physical and reports that this is so. Rebazaar even brings some reptilians into Sandy's presence for this very purpose, so they may have the opportunity also to become more aware.